Oh, we're getting the switch up. We're going into the darkness. We're using DLC Pack 2. We're getting that $5.99 special with Tyler Mithra.
One, go!
We'll see how this goes.
Get it!
Killing each other out. Not really established control yet. See if Jason's able to get off of this grab. Another grab. He's out. They will start the old KO combo.
Right here.
Able to whiff time through the pyro pressure. And is taking him on a trip to the left side. Interesting choice to switch from pyro to Mithra to pyro. I feel like you really want Mithra speed when you're dealing with the demon that is Bayonetta. Their way back in.
So close.
Nice grab. Taking anything off the edge guard. Okay. Yep. Missed the tag. Also gets covered by the Bayonetta down smash. KCD hasn't even gone above, has just gone above 70, so this is not looking great so far for the Mr. Pyra. I'm wondering if we're going to be switching back to the Rob in this game. Alright, not able to get the down tilt up there confirmed. Wonder if we're going to see a switch next game, or if he's going to stick it out. KCD really just has to chip him out and eventually get whatever jump works. There is a character that I can steal stomp. It's definitely Pyro Mithra. So I won't completely count Ampersand out yet. He's taking out the smash attack. Let's see if he can get Ampersand slipping. Unable to. Very good. Confirming. Gotta respect how much Ampersand been able to keep himself in the game. Even though he was, at a certain point, he was down 3-1 stock. And as I say that, his one stock comes to an end. It's okay. I always use that first game as data collection. As potential reason to switch characters, potentially. Now we're going through the stage striking process. Where does he not want to play against Bayonetta?
Stunt battle! Mithra, Bayonetta!
Sticking out with the Fire Mithra, let's see how this goes. Game one, but they are still hitting. And it's Oh, very, very lucky for Anderson. Well, very skilled for Anderson that they were able to land off stage instead of being sent to the dark pit. So you can get a down tilt up there. Assuming that the Bayo was too high percent. Get on stage. Oh, that was a good problem to roll back to stage. Really trying to get that kill with Pyro, but was unable to and has lost another stock. I like the way for the switch. Wasn't able to follow up off of the switch quickly enough. Was able to get the kill with the F tilt at ledge. So we got another Bayo combo started. He came off the Angel platform with violence. Not very long. That is the second game going to JCB. Bayonetta has been
dreadful.
Suffocated in his pressure on the Pyromitha. Bro, that verse 3-0 was so impressive, bro. That was hype. I saw you literally learning in time, and you figured it out. I was so impressed, bro. Alright, we got game 3 on PS2.
One, go!
We got the trusty Rod back. Let's see if he's able to punish Bayonetta more easily than Pyromitha was getting punished in the earlier 2 games. But there's also the fact that Bayonetta used Rob as clutch in terms of combo food, so he's gotta be wary about that. Oh no, he's able to get started with the down tilt. Not able to follow up. Oh, but able to follow up after waiting a bit. Gets the fair. Interesting to see how KCD is able to use this time to avoid the pressure Rob usually exerts using super top. Much more even so far this game than the past two, though. See if we can get some ledge cover. We get dead guard. KCD's able to come back with violence. KCD's waist gets the jab, which should kill. That's a pretty good buff for Bayonetta, I would say. Bayonetta head is probably really heavy today to hit her jab kill like that. But ampersand from second one, so up air. Seal up the stock. We are 0-0. Started using the Bayo combo, not much off there. Just related to up air, let's see if we can continue the advantage stay here. We'll go back to neutral. Alright, there's. Now we see if he takes back his advantage, let's see if we can take it to the top. So not ampersand, it's still in one piece.
So close.
For how long? That heavy body of Rob helps him survive the back air. We got a Rob there and up air. A couple more percent, that'll be a little more dangerous. Another up tilt, up air, and it just kills. I think that was viable, perhaps not. Bayonetta is pretty light in all honesty. Now falling up air, but not able to continue off the back. Now, we got Casey. He's going with a Bayonetta pressure, trying to keep his stock up. Possible hit. Falls out the rock, gets him in. We got a Bayo combo going. Essentially even. Ampersand trying to get him started here. Up tilt. We got him taking him off stage. And refusing to let him come back. Just saying no. Kicking him in the chest to end the set. You know, gotta respect, it's kinda tough to be put through a cutscene like that. But that'll be KCD taking that 3-0. Alright. I think that'll be me signing up on commentary, I think. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.